The adoption of intensive mango management systems is likely to be a game changer for the Australian mango industry. Advances have been made already in the apple and pear industry, where yields have increased from 10 tonne per hectare up to over 100 tonnes per hectare. Mangoes, which are currently sitting about 10 tonnes per hectare, have a great potential to also achieve similar yield increases. What we're aiming for is what we call a fruit wall. All the fruit will just be on the outside of the tree. This will make harvesting so much easier for either hand picking or eventually, as new technologies come along, for vision sensing or even robotic picking. Another advantage of the trellis systems is improved cyclone resilience. These pole and wire structures provide quite a bit of strength to the trees, and a number of examples in the wet tropics have found that trees growing on trellis systems are much more resilient to high winds and cyclonic winds. In a conventional Australian mango orchard, mango trees are grown as quite tall trees and have very large canopies. This is quite inefficient when it comes to utilising light. We have a lot of problems controlling the vigour of the trees because mangoes are a very vigorous tree, and our fruit yields are actually quite low compared to other tropical or subtropical fruit varieties. The first trials were established here at Walkham Research Station about 6 years ago. These trials investigate a range of orchard management systems using either trellised or non-trellised techniques compared with conventional mango growing technologies. The trees will only be maintained to a height of about 3 metres. Because of those heights, the rows can be positioned quite closely together. The canopies are very narrow, so it's achieving much better light utilisation per square metre. On a trellis system, we're bending the branches, and that reduces vigour and minimises the amount of vegetative growth and canopy growth. So that conserves resources in which the tree can then put into fruit. And so we're getting much higher yields on these systems. And the early indications are up to even 5 times yield increases, depending what variety we're growing.
If we were to be training the espalier method, we would be bending the two branches on either side, our laterals, to encourage growth along this first wire and keeping one apical dominant branch to travel straight up to the next wire. If this was the palmate training system, more like the palm of your hand, we wouldn't be folding the branches down as harshly, just keeping maybe a 45 degree angle or so and tying these to that bottom branch. And again, keeping an apical dominant branch to travel up to the next wire. Establishing a trellis is quite an upfront cost, as well as quite a bit of extra work. So we've got these other systems here without the trellis. We've got a system called a single leader. And so when we come to training these trees, we're bending the branches down to reduce that vigour, and we would tie off at the end of each of these to a point on the ground. By reducing our vigour, again, we're putting more energy into flowering and fruiting. We've also got some trees growing in a conventional way, as you would now. So these will be just pruned in your usual open vase shape, just planted at a higher density.
So a big advantage of high density systems is where we've got limited resources such as land or water. Where we can't expand into new areas, we can better utilise the land that we have. This property, owned by Mambaloo Limited, was the first site established as part of the Transforming Mango Futures project. At this site, the growers are looking at the 4 mango intensification techniques. 2 of those involve trellis systems, and 2 of those involve high density non-trellis systems. We're hoping that at this spacing, the trees will reach their mature size within about 5 to 6 years. And already the trees are growing very well.